Okay, here we are previewing another sale at Clark, this time coming up on March the 5th, just prior to St. Patrick's Day. So we need to sell lots of items to get the money to enjoy St. Patrick's Day. We have a wonderful sale here, better than usual, although I say that every sale. In fact, the sale coming up next month is even better because Keen has some great mid-century, which he'll talk about. Anyway, I'm going to start here with this wonderful pair of gilt and paint decorated pedestals, probably 19th century, late 19th century, early 20th, but beautifully carved, very decorative. Came from a Greenwich, Connecticut estate. Atop this, this is one of a pair of wonderful Rococo carved and gilt wood mirrors. Italian 20th century, but really nice, nice gilding and nice quality and nice to have a pair. Moving right along here, and the furniture, of which we have some very strong French furniture as well. We have this gilt metal pair of two-tier malachite tables, possibly bronze. I believe they are bronze. Nice claw feet on them, but we'll look at the grain on the malachite. Same on the pair, and it's two tiers. These are wonderful. These are estimated, I believe, 3,000 to 5,000. On top of them, we have a pair of hens or cocks, bronze mounted, triple light candelabra from our estate in Sutton Place, South, where this wonderful commode came from. This commode, look at the bronze mounting on it. Fine, fine quality bronze just dribbling off it. It's signed on the lock, Paul Sormani. It's also signed twice on the actual cabinet underneath the marble. What a wonderful thick marble, nice original condition. This, I believe, is estimated 15,000 to 25,000. It also came from Sutton Place. It's here to sell. It is unreserved. On top of that, a beautiful bronze and patinated clock. Also came from the city around 61st Street, I believe. Over here, we have lots of used furniture. Look at these nice paisley upholstered pair of club chairs, nice and comfortable. And before we move over here, on top of this, we have a wonderful bronze, look, a silvered bronze by an artist called Sykes. Nice large size, bit of staining on the patina, but this is the Rolls-Royce insignia. The flying, won't even get into it, I can't think about that, but something is flying anyway. Over here, look at this absolutely wonderful serpentine front, 18th century Italian, possibly German, walnut commode with the rosewood banding, the bone inlay. It's actually dated 1788. Wonderful condition, wonderful patina, all the original locks as you like it. Wonderful. Okay, here in the same vein, we have a pair of bronze and patinated putti form candelabra. Musical putti, no less. I believe the putties are 13 inches, so it gives you an idea of the size of the candelabra. Rare to find, nice pair. And here from Premium Point, New Rochelle, a wonderful pair. You never see another pair of this size of Doré bronze hurricane chandeliers. Nice beveled glass. Absolutely wonderful. Before we move in the main room, we have this absolutely beautiful little French Art Nouveau table. Bronze mounted, wonderful bronze work. I believe it has one drawer. A nice inlay, sort of in the style of Gallet or one of those French artisans. I don't see a signature on it, but it's definitely a good maker. Wonderful quality. We have lots of Art Nouveau stuff on the sale, plenty of vitrines, which I'm going to show you. All came from the city also. Actually, here we are. We'll start here with some of them. There's a wonderful little inlaid table, also in the style of Gallet. I believe it's signed illegibly, but has a signature on it. Nice period table, some little staining on it. Next to it, a vitrine. Very, very, very Art Nouveau looking with the carved tree, a little bit as is here. But this is signed Gautier, C. Gautier. Moving right along, we got some nice Chinese in the sale. We have this hard stone lamp. In here, we got some nice porcelain. We have some nice Meissen in the sale. Look at this for a boar, nice big boar. Looking like he's enjoying himself there. He's getting ready for Paddy's Day. He's in the mode. We've got this Meissen figure with the pug dogs. We have this very nice little Meissen caddy or urn, whatever it is with the lid. Nice early piece, came out of Sotheby's originally. That's one lot. We have lots of Parian porcelain. We have lots of bronzes. We have that bronze by Etner, who did the, I believe, the 1 cent. We had a bronze by him before of Adam and Eve, did very well. We have lots of clocks. This is a German bronze and porcelain figural clock. And here we have a large collection of Tiffany Doré bronze. It's a writing set, all the pieces are there. That's a Sevres Parian porcelain. We have LeCoultre clocks. We have Cartier clocks. We have tea caddies. We have some African sculpture in the sale. This is a fetish figure. Just this one here. We have other ones that you'll go onto our site, clarkny.com, to view. And here, newer, but in a very nice quality, nice, and the fact that there's four of them, you can stick them on your wall in the house or anywhere. Four putties, nice big size, solid marble. We got lots of carpets in the sale. We've this Kerman below us. Moving right along, we have this wonderful lamp. It's very sort of mid-century looking, but look at the stone on that. It's like amethyst, but a very, very nice big chandelier lamp with a shade. Up here, we've got some good period American furniture in it. We have this tiger maple chest. We have some nice Queen Anne style highboys in the style that came from the same estate, I believe, up in Westport. And here in the Art Nouveau vein, we have this wonderful marble bronze mounted pedestal. Look at the work on that. Okay, beautiful Art Nouveau. And below here, we have a very nice Chinese Art Deco carpet, probably Nichols. Nice shape, not a lot of wear in it. Nice room size carpet. Came from Garden City, Long Island. And here, sitting on top of the carpet from a local estate, is a, I believe, a nice early 19th or 18th century marble top bureau plat. It's nice with the pullouts, nice condition, nice bronze mounts. And here, from an East 57th Street, see my good Irish memory, remembering all the estates I was in. Look at this wonderful patina, this mahogany serpentine and bow front commode. Nice splayed feet, as nice as you get, even though it's not absolutely in mode. Here we have some actually very good quality 20th century reproduction tables. The best of quality reproduction. And from the Art Nouveau that came in the city, I really like this. Look at the shape in this. It's sort of in the style of Lulieu. Maybe it is Lulieu. Nice brass mounted marble top. Look at the grain in that. Nearly like a rosewood or walnut grain. And alongside it, the matching table. This all came from 57th Street. Look at the brass trim and the grain and the woodwork on that table. As we're moving along, you'll see there are a lot of vitrines came from this estate. This is probably an English one, very Art Nouveau as well, with the mahogany and the inlay and the nice leaded glass pane. And here from a local estate, another French commode. You know, not as groovy as the Sormani, I would say, but beautiful, probably 18th century, nice bronze work on it, nice inlays. Beautiful thick marble, a little bit as is, but what can we say? And here in the used furniture from the Greenwich Estates, we have a triple pedestal banded table together with 3, 6, 8 chairs, 10 chairs. 8 side, 2 arms, wonderful patina, wonderful condition, nice banding. Maybe it's back in vogue and hopefully we get some people who want that. Now is the time to buy these sets if you want them, because they do come back. You'll be paying 5 times the amount. Here, reproduction, but a nice black lacquered bronze mounted marble top commode. Pair of stickly Audi chairs. More mahogany used furniture. A woman rang me and asked me to go over this chandelier while we did the video, because she couldn't understand why there was a strange brass piece here. So I'm going to show you. It's actually the top. That's the piece that goes up onto the top. So the chandelier is in good shape. This came from Sutton Place, continental style. A Swedishy looking chandelier. Oop. Put it back on there so we don't lose it. It still has the shades. They're dirty. We're not selling them with the shades. Okay, moving along here, we have grandfather clocks. More Art Nouveau vitrines. We won't venture too far into the back room, but we have a nice little collection of Regency furniture that came from the Beresford on Central Park West. I have to keep going because we have a nice English desk. It's sort of as is, but you don't see this maker too often. It's signed Gillows. It's a very good English maker, probably Victorian. Nice burl walnut lacquered with a leather top. It's as is, it can be restored, but nice for the fact that it's Gillows and we've these little Regency pieces here, came from the same estate. Let me get you moving here because I know the other appraisals are anxious. Before we swing to the end, we have 2 pianos in the sale. One is this absolutely beautiful Steinway. I'm sure Faith Lieberman will be able to play it over the weekend and give us her opinion. We have Regency rows with game tables. We have a Wayne Pratt table there. We have another beautiful piano, probably a dark walnut by Young Chang, no less. The Bowl Young Chang is the maker on that. And here I just want to pay special note for our Chinese buyers. This is a wonderful antique cinnabar piece. A little bit as is, but rare to find. We have lots of tea caddies in this sale. This is just a selection of some of them. Just look at the color on that. I think we have about 4 lots of tea caddies in various estimates. We have some Royal Copenhagen figures here that are very rare. We have Lalique, we have Baccarat, we have Murano. We have a lot of KPM plaques in the sale. I think about six of them, which are really wonderful. We have this Flora Danica, set of 12. I think estimated 2,000 to 3,000 or 1,015 for the 12. Moving right along, we have Royal Dalton porcelain with Kultur clocks. Look at this wonderful, wonderful, large size Chinese porcelain plaque or gold signed on the back. Okay, and before I go, I'm just going to show you a few of the six KPM porcelain plaques. This is one here of a beauty walking down the steps. Here's another one of a beauty. She's thinking about Patrick's Day coming up. Look at the vacant mood on her there. Here we have another woman. She's lying against a tree, probably après Patrick's Day. And with that, I'm going to wish you all goodbye and hopefully see you here on Sunday, March the 5th at 12 noon. We start. The previews are 2 days prior, Friday and Saturday from noon to 6, or you can view us at clarkny.com, live bidding at bidsquare.com and liveauctioneers.com. Thank you.
Hi, welcome to our preview of the March 5th Fine Art. I'd like to start by showing you an oil painting on canvas done by Irene Sierra Carreno. She's a relative of the well-known Cuban modernist Mario Carreno, also active in Cuba, and known for these sort of fanciful, colorful, imaginative landscapes. This one here is called Eve's Hammock. This was actually executed in 2001. She is a contemporary artist, but commands pretty strong prices at auction. This work is being offered with a $6,000 to $9,000 estimate. I'd like to show you another Latin American work. This one here is by Guerrero Galvin. This one's done in 1961, and he was part of the Mexican muralist movement, but also a well-known Mexican figure painter. So here we have a girl holding a dove, a very typical painting of the artist, nice bright colors here. And this was actually purchased in Mexico in the 1960s. We do have a gallery label on the back of the work. I'll show you two other paintings from that estate in just a moment. Now I'd like to show you a wonderful oil on board by the well-known Johan Berthelsen. We've had many of his works come through our gallery in the last few years. This one though I think is quite special. It's a nice large size and it's a view of Fifth Avenue in the snow. We've got flags blowing in the wind, wonderful atmospheric effect of the snow. And it is in good original condition. It does need a little bit of cleaning. You can see some of the whites have yellowed a bit. This was actually shipped to us from a home in London. This is offered with a $4,000 to $6,000 estimate. One of the most important works in this sale is an oil on canvas by Willard Metcalf. Here we have the small painting of sheep grazing in landscape, and it's signed W.L. Metcalf in the lower left corner and dated 1878. The American Impressionist artist was only about 20 years old when this was painted, and you can see this is fresh from an estate, also a bit yellowed, has never been touched, or original dirt as we found it. This is being offered with an $8,000 to $12,000 estimate. We do believe it's a New England scene, so we're excited to see what happens with this one on Sunday. And down below, we have another work by a very well-known American painter. This is Louis Elshemis. It's an oil painted on a board, as his works typically are, and we have bathers in a landscape. Perhaps a made-up landscape, we're not sure, though he did spend some time on the West Coast. But you can see the period swimsuits here, which I just love. Wonderful subject matter, and his very typical light and atmospheric palette, but also sort of naive, signed in the lower right corner. Nice big size for the artist, estimated at 3,000 to 5,000. From a Sutton Place South estate comes a painting by Walter Lazzaro. Here we have an oil on board of the white boat, and he was known as the painter of silence. And that's exactly what we have here, a solitary boat in landscape, and a very typical painting for the artist with one single object in the center of the canvas or to the side of the canvas, but quite an evocative work. This was done in 1988 and is being offered with a $2,000 to $4,000 estimate. I've already shown you two Latin American paintings. We have another one by Gustavo Montoya. And if you recall our last sale, we had a portrait of a boy by Montoya, important Mexican artist from the 50s and 60s. As a result of the $10,000 sale on that painting, we had two market scenes consigned this month. This one here called Mercado, done in 1958 with the Mexican gallery label on the back, and a wonderful intricate painting, a painting of everyday life. You'll have to take a look at the website for the mate to this painting that was done in 1959. Each one of these works is being offered at a $3,000 to $5,000 estimate. I'm very excited about this gouache on paper that came in also in a walk-in Wednesday. This is by Ludwig Bemelmans, the creator and illustrator of the beloved Madeleine stories. So here we have a view of Paris. It's too bad we don't have 12 little girls in two straight lines in this painting, but nonetheless, we have a wonderful view of the Seine with Notre Dame Cathedral and the added personal touch of the terrace on the side. Just a fantastic painting. This is being offered at $1,000 to $1,500. Now up above, I'd like to show you a small little abstract painting. This is by Helena Maria Vieira da Silva. She was a Portuguese-born French painter, an important abstract expressionist. This work was done in 1968, and though it's a small painting, it is a strong painting. It was included in the catalog Raisonné and is being offered with a $2,000 to $4,000 estimate. I'd like to show you one bronze sculpture before we head into the next room. This is a work after Jacques Lipschitz. It's signed and dated 1922, and it's a wonderful abstract of a figure playing a guitar and a nice large size, nice patina on it. It does seem to have the age. It, unfortunately, not numbered. If it were from the numbered edition, it would command quite a bit more, but it is a really strong bronze, wonderful composition. There's also a number of these done in a terracotta and a ceramic, I believe. This is being offered with a $1,000 to $1,500 estimate. I have one more Latin piece to show you, and it's a mixed media on canvas by Vicente Riojo. Here we have the work. You can see a wonderfully textured and colorful piece. It's called Four Pyramids. We have a gallery label from Madrid on the back. He was born in Spain, but became one of Mexico's really most important abstract painters. So here we have an oil mixed with another medium to create this texture. A lot of his works are heavily textured, either in composition or in actual physical space, which is what we have here. This is being offered with a $2,000 to $4,000 estimate. And one last piece I'd like to show you is a work by Mark Costabi. And here we have figures descending a staircase done in 1982. Signed down in the corner, but also on the back of the work. And this is also an early work by the artist. He actually moved to New York City in 1982 before becoming the East Village art scene's kind of famed artist. This here is being offered at a $2,000 to $3,000 estimate. Please take a look at our online catalog for the rest of the works coming up on March 5th, and we hope to see you at the sale. Thank you.
Hey everyone, we actually have two great sales coming up, so I'm gonna jump ahead a little bit to March 26th before we go into the March 5th sale. Right in the front hall here, we have a few of the featured pieces that are viewable when you come in for the previews for the March 5th sale, as well as online currently. The first is a gorgeous Paul Evans polychrome geometric signed and dated center table, dining table. The colors on this are spectacular. Usually you see them really worn out or scratched away, but this is a great, great example. It even has a little bit of the blues and greens in there as well as the yellows and the reds. Signed PE68 and has all this great symbology that Paul Evans Studio is pretty known for in these particular pieces. Also, we have really exceptional set of dressers here. These are Geoponti for M. Singer. Both of them are labeled in the drawer interior. The patina on them is really nice. They are single owner, estate fresh, used, and they are just gorgeous, gorgeous early pieces and still very functional. They were used as dressers until the day we took them out of the house, and estimated 25 to 35,000. As you know, these single pieces could do very well, but a pair is even more exceptional to have, and something I'm really excited to see in the March 26th sale. Okay, so we'll go into the main room for the March 5th sale. This is the most immediate sale coming up this Sunday. We have lots of great stuff. You can see Mariani leather and chrome settee. It's a great size. Leather has nice little bit of wear, kind of gives it that vintage feel to it because it is vintage, of course. We also have a set of chests, John Stewart. This Gentleman's chest with fitted interior, also together with a low dresser. Nice set here, very clean. Pair of Parsinger end tables. These are nice little Sherrick modern end tables, delicate lines on these, really decorative pieces. Those are one lot of many Parsinger original pieces that we have coming up, so I'll show you those as we walk through. Also has a really sweet set. This is a Pace chrome set. There are four chairs with the suede strapping. Nice clean chrome and brass table here. Nice dinette set for a smaller apartment or just a featured dinette room. So we also have Paul Frankel, a very large and complete bedroom set. There is a headboard and a footboard. There are two end tables. There's a pair of dressers and a tall dresser. They do probably need to be refinished. They do have a little bit of off-whiting here, but complete set, great patina to the brass poles, and these usually do pretty well. So as a whole set, I think you're getting a pretty good exposure to these pieces. So I'll also take you right here to the largest and probably the most expensive Parsinger piece that we have in the sale coming up. This is a two-piece original finish Parsinger Originals cabinet. It does have a fitted interior. You can see the red underlay of that. Interior is still excellent. Has that typical Parsinger look. You'll see from the same house we have another matching piece that has this similar color, so you can see that there was a theme within the estate. This actually comes from a Scarsdale estate of Parsinger's personal accountant. He was gifted these pieces by Parsinger himself, hopefully not in lieu of payment, but you know, you never know. So this is also pretty cool to have the original retrofitted pieces in there. For the audio cabinet, like I said, this is a two-piece Parsinger cabinet that comes into one large credenza. The finish is really good. I wouldn't touch it, but that's obviously up to the end buyer. We also have a bunch of Danish modern, some generic, some designer dining table. This is a pretty clean set, six chairs, two leaves to the table, very clean teak set, can't go wrong. So we're jumping to the middle of the hall here with some continuation of the Parsinger selection. This is a super loud and really cool vintage upholstered in silk, no less, Parsinger three-seat sofa. The frame on this is in excellent structural condition. There's a few bumps on the legs, not a big deal. This funky fabric does have a little wear and a few areas of losses, but overall shows you the feel and the attitude of the time period of which this was originally made and purchased, and something really cool to see, whether it's reupholstered down the line or not, not a big deal. So in front of that, you also see, as I mentioned, another piece comes from the same estate as the rest of the Parsinger originals, and this is the orange base and great weight coffee table. The textured steel on the outside of the frame has a really nice touch to this, and you can see that even though it does have a few areas of wear spots, it does have that same red underlay as the cabinet that we saw a few minutes ago. May need to be refinished, but overall this is a great example of an early Parsinger piece. In front of that, we also have two Rob's John Gibbings benches. Unfortunately, these have been modified a little bit. They do have an underlaying structure that just keeps it together, obviously just to strengthen the legs of it, but nice to have a pair of those as well. And in the middle here, highly recognizable, coming back to the Italian design, the Trianel floor lamp by Artolucci. This one has the marble circular base rather than the star base, maybe a little bit later, but has all the makings of a great, great lot, and usually these do pretty well, so I'm happy to have this. I'm gonna spin you around now, something that we might have glanced by before, but one of the final Parsinger pieces that we have in the sale. This is a single tub chair, lounge chair, also with a pretty loud fabric, but it's also a excellent form for a chair. One of my favorite pieces, has a very delicate saber legs, has this cushion that is custom fitted, and you can see how it has the open back and the sides there and the black lacquer. It's a really quality design, and there's no wonder why Parsinger made such elegant and was so popular in his elegant designs. So finally, we have some more American design in Eames for aluminum group chair. This is in the vinyl, of course, but the black in good condition, vintage wear and vintage use, but really nice to see the original fabric and the original condition on these. Estimated 600 to 900 should do pretty well as well. Something that I like, very functional. And with that, I will remind you to take a look at the website for March 26th. But in the meantime, we'll see you on March 5th for the sale. Thanks.
Today, I'll be presenting you with a grouping of jewelry and sterling for our March 5th auction. Starting here, we have this great grouping of tazas or compotes, sterling silver, applied grape and leaf motif, three together with an estimate of 600 to 900. Here we have a pair of small Tiffany clover pattern bowls, estimated at 400 to 600, and conveniently from a separate estate, this much larger Tiffany clover pattern bowl out of a Manhattan estate. Moving on with some additional Tiffany, we have this pair of compotes or tazas, nice modern design, pedestal base. Moving on here, we have a grouping of perfume bottles, some Tiffany antique pieces, really nice. This is one of my favorites. Nice fitted tortoise shell vessel, lid, really quite beautiful. And here's a large Tiffany & Company San Lorenzo pattern flatware service. Over 100 troy ounces of silver, really beautiful, out of a New Jersey estate. Silver plate, ornate candlesticks. Let me just move to this side. Antique English pedestal cups, beautiful shell design, really nice condition. Assorted grouping of silver, some additional groupings of silver. This is a nice sugar caster, gorham. Some interesting flatware, coin, silver, etc. Grouping of silver plate tankards out of a local estate, some weighted silver items, Reed and Barton, all aesthetic movement. They really are quite lovely. This one's beautiful, floral design. Really nice, all have the liners. Estimated at 300 to 500. And moving on to another showcase, we have this Cartier desk clock. This is also a Grogan & Company desk clock. Estimated 400 to 600, 300 to 500. This is an antique, sorry about that, most probably German, 800 silver. I'm sure that it once housed a large glass center bowl, but right now it's just the base. More groupings of miscellaneous silver. Here's a grouping of kiddish cups out of Bedford, and a very sweet pair of silver plate reindeer form candelabra. Really nice, unmarked, but sweet. And here we have a large grouping of silver. If you need a silver tea set, this is the sale for you. A really large assortment for you. Here we have a large Howard & Company tea service. Six pieces, the tray is also sterling. It's around 330 troy ounces, estimated at 3,000 to 5,000 from a Manhattan estate, all dated 1898. And starting with a few pieces of antique English silver, we have this grouping of four George III footed salts, beautiful ornate design, little footed Asian figures, really, really sweet, all marked on the bottom, gold washed to the interior. And from the same estate, we have this George IV teapot, ex Sotheby's. Really nice, along with this little miscellaneous child's cup. Here we have a green guilloche enamel sterling cocktail shaker with the four cups. Cups do have gold washed to the interiors. Really beautiful engine turn design, etched glass. There is a little bit of a condition issue here, but a lovely set estimated at 300 to 500. James Dixon and Son, four piece sterling tea service, along with this English silver, late 19th century English teapot, similar design. Also with this American, similar design sterling, waste vessel, and a James Dixon silver plate tray. Nice grouping, all estimated at 1,000 to 1,500. And one of the most interesting pieces in this auction is this late 17th century William and Mary caudle cup. In the later half of the 17th century, these caudal cups were used post-pregnancy for some combination of porridge and wine for the mothers. Beautiful design to this piece, Asian figures with kites and floral design. You can see also more design on this side. There are a few condition issues, but beautifully stamped on the bottom, and also inscribed Macy Plant 1917. Macy Plant, she was married to Morton F. Plant, who once owned the Cartier building, well, what is now the Cartier building in Manhattan. He sold that building for $100 and a perfectly matched single strand of pearls. It's an interesting story. You should probably Google that because it is great provenance for this piece. Unfortunately, the lid is not a match, so this is a later English lid, but it does fit on here quite nicely and it's aesthetically pleasing to the piece. Estimated at 1500 to 2000, and it's dated 1689. Here we have a Cartier sterling scalloped edge or shaped edge tray. Nice weight to this piece, estimated at, I believe, 400 to 600. Another tea service, here's a Mexican silver tea service. Three pieces, beautiful floral form finials. Nice design. This only condition issue here is that it doesn't really fit quite properly at the moment, but that's an easy repair. And here is a three-piece set of Gorham Etruscan serving ware, round tray, beautiful Greek key design, along with this pair of open vegetables. All Gorham Etruscan pattern, really quite nice and good condition. And here we have a six-piece Reed and Barton tea service on the matched silver plate tray. Great condition, monogrammed, but really lovely. And here's one of our many flatware services in this sale. This is International Sterling Royal Danish, popular pattern. Nice condition, needs to be polished, but really ready to use. And also a Gorham Rocco pattern flatware service. Nice weight, lots of pieces. And here we have an antique Irish tea service out of a Manhattan estate, Dublin City stamps, and it's by Robert W. Smith, late 19th century. Beautiful floral or fruit finials, etched design to the body of the vessels, estimated at 1,000 to 1,500. Moving on to another tea service, we have this five-piece Tuttle's tea service out of Manhattan. Beautiful condition with this nice silver plate tray, pierced gallery, nice piece from Manhattan. And this, just want to give a quick overview, it's a really wonderful collection of snuff bottles. Mostly antique, some American, but most of them are continental. We have Dutch, there's one Asian. This is one of my favorites. Beautiful food dragon or food dog design to this piece. All of the information is available online. There's some Victorian mourning pieces, a small Queen Elizabeth pill box. Really nice collection, estimated at 1,000 to 1,500. All right, last but not least for silver items, we have this nice silver plate teapot, kind of an Arabian man or prince on a camel. Nice condition with the original box. This is estimated at 300 to 500. Two Menaudiers in the sale. We have this Karen Hoffman design. Beautiful tropical fish with Swarovski crystals. And the ever popular Judith Lieber. Nice pearl closure on the interior. There is the strap on both of these. The tropical fish also does come with additional crystals if any are loose, which I believe there may be a few missing, but there's plenty inside. Now moving on to our jewelry, we have a great collection of men's watches in the sale. Here we have an 18 karat moon phase Audemars, estimated at 2,000 to 3,000. Really lovely face to this piece. And here we have an 18 karat gold Piaget, same estate. A ladies Tiffany & Company gunmetal design watch, really nice. Moving on to some earrings here, we have these black and gold and rose cut diamond earrings, nearly 5 carats of diamonds. And here's this beautiful cocktail ring, a nearly 6-carat rubellite with a surround of diamonds set in 18-carat yellow gold. GIA certificate solitaire diamond engagement ring. It's approximately 1.14 carats, K color and I1 clarity, estimated at $1,000 to $1,500. And here is a great grouping of kind of beaded necklaces. We have cinnabar, turquoise, tiger's eye, and then this is really a lovely Baltic amber necklace. Large beads, large size, graduated by consignor provenance. This was brought back by her grandmother in Poland. All these pieces together estimated at $300 to $500. And last but not least for our men's watches, we have this lovely Oyster Perpetual Rolex men's watch. Original box, original receipts, original paperwork. It was purchased at Tourneau. Really nice, estimated at $1,000 to $1,500. 14-carat yellow gold and carved white jade pendant. Large size, beautiful carving, bats and flowers. Estimated at $300 to $500. And here out of Manhattan estate, we have this synthetic alexandrite color change bracelet set in 14-carat yellow gold. In other types of light, this is a beautiful maroon color. Really interesting, these color change stones, I quite like them. And here we have a blackened pearl, rose cut diamond, and seed pearl pair of earrings. Nice size, beautiful, popular chandelier form earrings. And we'll move on to our collection of bracelets. 18 karat Italian gold, white gold and yellow gold, geometric design out of Manhattan. Same estate, 18 karat gold, really beautiful, beautifully articulated bracelet. Great movement to this piece. And out of a local estate, we have this 14 karat brushed gold bracelet, beautifully articulated again. And it is nice that it does come with this additional link. If it isn't the appropriate size, you can have this added back on quite easily. An interesting grouping in this auction is this grouping of amber. So some of it does happen to be costume, but it all came together, so that's how it's being displayed for you and offered. This is a great cane or umbrella handle, a large amber bead here. Interesting, we have some butterscotch amber, another Baltic amber strand, and this is probably the nicest piece in this sale. Great, great antique amber. Estimated at $600 to $900. And moving on to another piece with a little bit of history. This is a Bailey Banks and Biddle 14 and 18 karat gold Magna Charta brooch. So it is this enamel decorated seal, and then this is a scroll form enamel decorated pendant that has part of the Magna Charta on here. Another interesting aspect of this piece is that we have somehow obtained a copy of the original Bailey Banks and Biddle jewelry ledger for the creation of this piece. It is also signed on the back. Tillman, who his family actually, it dates back to when the Magna Charta was actually originally signed, and his father did actually serve in the Civil War. So it's an interesting piece with a little bit of history, estimated at $1,000 to $1,500. Also from our Manhattan estate, we have this large opal with a surround of diamonds, really great size to these diamonds, and it's set in white gold and yellow gold. Really quite nice, great sparkle to those diamonds. And here we have a pair of 18 karat yellow gold and aventurine seamanship cufflinks in the original box. Really nice pair. And going back to two additional pieces of silver before I end my segment, we have this beautiful late 19th century Gorham leaf form bowl. Really nice organic finish to this piece. So there's all these beautiful imperfections that just make it really just so unusual and beautiful. And a great leaf design here. This is estimated at $300 to $500. And here, so sweet, we have this little Christoffel silver plate toothpick holder with a little monkey on an elephant holding an umbrella. It's really just so sweet. And it's estimated at $300 to $500. And that wraps it up for my section of jewelry and silver. And we hope to see you on March 5th. Thank you.